So I'm writing all these stories about Wall Street. A lot of them are involve these either criminal or quasi-criminal capers. And the punchline to all these stories is the same. Nobody ever gets indicted. Nobody goes to jail. And right around the time of the Occupy protest, I decided to write a book about this, that particular part of the phenomenon, what was going on at the enforcement level, and why was there no enforcement in response to what had taken place in 2008. And in order to do that story, I realized I had to learn more about who does go to jail in America and why, and that sent me off on this very strange odyssey into the criminal justice system and what happens to people who are undocumented or on welfare, who just live in poor neighborhoods. And so this book sort of evolved into a big compare and contrast exercise, where I'm really alternating back and forth between these two worlds and trying, almost without arguing, I'm trying just to show the two different ways that the criminal justice system works for these two different types of offenders. But I do think that there's an emotional imperative that underpins a lot of this phenomena in the criminal justice system. I think, I saw it in the eyes of judges when they looked at certain kinds of defendants versus the way they looked at certain kinds of white-collar defendants and how they treated the defense counsel for certain kinds of criminals versus how they treated the defense counsel for people who were charged with say, for instance, municipal bond bid rigging. And these are some of the highest paid lawyers in America. They were very willing to engage in these sort of intellectual colloquies with those types of attorneys, and they didn't look down upon the defendants in the same way that they looked down upon the defendants who came into the ordinary street courts. And I just think Americans think of people at the very bottom strata of society as being parasites who are living off of our tax dollars, and there's a tremendous hostility that they all have to go through just to get through every single day. And this was a consistent feature of all the interviews that I did with these people, that not only did they have a hard time in the justice system, but they continually experience humiliation, anger, and a kind of sneering disapproval from everybody that they encountered in government, whereas I would think the opposite is true on the other side.